Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews. I'm in little literary corner here at the moment. I've got kind of in where my library is. I've got all sorts of books everywhere and all sorts. But I'm in my little literary corner because we've got a literary connection. We've got a very special beer. Or well, I've got a couple of special beers that I'm going to, excuse me, knitting, that I'm going to be going for here. Both by Eldridge Pope. Very, very, very old, this one. This is Thomas Hardy's Ale. And it is Eldridge Pope. And as you can see, where are we? 1974. Now, on the back here, I don't know if you can read this on the back. It says, this beer will... Now, look, hold on, I'll read it to you right way round in a minute. Got all the kind of thing on there, the tab and everything. And it says, in the trumpet major. Wait a minute. I don't want to kind of move it around too much. In the trumpet, the yeast should be kind of well sorted by now, but I've had it sitting and everything else, but I don't want to shake it about. In the trumpet major, Hardy wrote of Dorchester's strong beer. It was of the most beautiful colour that the eye of an artist in beer could desire. Full of body, yet brisk as a volcano. Piquant, yet without a twang. I ain't got my glasses on, if you can notice. Luminous as an autumn, God, this is what you call a beer review, isn't it? This is an autumn sunset, free from streakiness of taste, but finally rather heady. There you go. Now that kind of describes it because, well, I haven't had this yet, obviously. 40 years old, just over 40 years old as it happens, because I think it was March, yeah, March. So I was saving it for my book, I was saving it for the release of the book and that I'm writing, the beer book and that. But I was hoping to release that by Christmas. But you know what? I'm kind of thinking I want a treat. I feel like a treat. I need a treat. So I'm having it before Christmas. I've got other beers that are specials. I've got, you know, the Ab 12 and I've got the Westie 12 and what I'm going to have together. And a few other very special ones. But, yeah, that's kind of a cool one. So, let's get the old BB Barfly. Let's whack it open. Another one I've got, by the way. Let me just put that just here from there. Have I got any Thomas Hardy? I ain't got Thomas Hardy, have I? Nope, never mind. Don't worry about it. I've got the same one, Eldridge Pope, but this one's a little bit kind of not as well kept. Well, it is well kept, but the label's got a bit muffed up. 1977 Coronation beer, which is why I've got the little coronation mugs and things here. I'll show you the mugs just quickly. This coronation mug from 77. It's 40 years old, and this one's very old. That's the actual coronation day itself. 53. There you go. Right, shall I get on with it? Shall I? I've got the nearest thing I've got to a posh glass. I kind of think this is the best glass for it. I don't really go for that glassware too much. So, you know, if you've got kind of like glass this and glass that, whatever, you know. I always think a good beer is a good beer, you know, out of a Foster's glass, out of a whatever, you know, you put a McLager or Foster's. I'm going to crack this open now, by the way. McLager or Foster's, just cut round. If I remember rightly, I'm going to need a corkscrew for this. Let's crack it open, I'm not sure. Oh, it's very, very solid. I think, I'm sure we've got a cork inside this as well. Have we? Nope. Oh. Now, as I say, it's going to be anything up to 20, where are we? 25 years, it said. But this smells glorious and it's 40 years old. So let's get that glass. See if I can pour it on the camera. I always ruin it, but trying my best on this. It's going to need help, I think, getting a bit of gas involved. And I'm pouring almost all of that, leaving a tiny bit. It's ever so slightly murky. Let's get something white behind there, maybe. Little envelope, little gas bill of some sort. Just, you can see down the bottom. It's really, really murky. And so let's give it a go. Let's have a little sniff. Let's have a little twirl and a little smell. Yeah, we ain't got much head on that. I don't know if we've got carbonation. Oh, good Lord. Jesus, that smells glorious. That smells so glorious. See, a lot of the time, you go a bit too old with some of these beers, you start to get murky and damp, sort of funny sort of smells. It's still nice, but it's funny sort of smells, and they go past. This has got beautiful smells. They're rounded out. You can still smell these hops there, but they're rounded and softened and just, you know, it's nothing attacking. It's toffees, lovely, glorious toffees. There's a bit of grape in the background. Kind of a bit of white grape, a bit of something like a Spätlese wine in the background. Oh, wow. Maybe old Riesling, maybe a Cabernet. Not Cabernet, Cabernet. With a K. I know it sounds poncy, but it's kind of different wines and things. And this is heading towards a German wine, isn't it? And those German grapes. Nice sort of sweetness to them. Oh, good Lord. There's all sorts of lovely little smells there. There's a tiny hints of tobacco there as well. But in a nice way. That kind of rough shag. Sort of. Nothing like a rough shag. I look like one of these old boys with a... Oh, sorry. Smells really, really gorgeous. Really gorgeous. Tiny little hints of little bread, nice toasty breads. There's little panettone, nice panettone taste hints in there. And you've got little currant-y notes. Oh, that is glorious. That is really glorious. I've got to taste it. Anyway, bottoms up. Cheers, everyone. Cheers to a few of the boys on Beer Advocate and that, and you know, for kind of saying hello to me and everything else. So hello, boys. He's kind of been going, what's going to happen? What's happening with the beer and that? They're going. So sorry about kind of leaving you in suspenders, isn't it? But this is raise a glass to you guys. Raise a glass to all you guys that watch the reviews and that. You make an happy man very old, you know. And all the fantastic brewers out there. Someone, get on this and start brewing it again. I think the last one was O'Hanlon's, I think, was doing it last time. And they've turned over to Hanlon's now. And they've dropped Brewer's Reserve, which was a fantastic beer. But look, they've still got some lovely beers. I think they've still got Port Stout and everything else. But someone, pick up the baton on it. This is a beautiful beer. And it needs brewing again. But this is an early one. So not many people will have one as early as this. And if you have, this is what it's going to taste like. So stop waffling, Tell, and get on with it. Feels like a special occasion. That's why I'm waffling so much. I'm quite excited. So, cheers everyone. Bottoms up. Chin chin. Cheers everybody. Thank you. Man, there is carbonation there. It's nice, it's gentle, very, very gentle, but there's carbonation just piffling on the tongue. gone red. Jesus. Oh, it burns the stomach as well when it goes in. But that is glorious. You've got Garibaldi biscuits. You've got a little hint of rum. A little hint of whiskey even. Kind of a good, actually not good single malt whiskey. You've got hints of White and Mackay whiskey in there, which is a good blended whiskey, a cheap one in there. I believe it's good anyway. That kind of caramel notes and that in there. There's lovely little caramel notes, but you can taste there's a fiery ABV in there. I don't know what the ABV is and whether it pumps up a little bit while it's in the bottle. And you know what ABV are we talking? Most probably on one this old, it'll probably say in what you call it, in specific gravity, original gravity or whatever. But it don't even say that. So we're showing that it's an old one, you know. Dear, oh dear. Right, let's give it another twirl. When you're drinking, when you're tasting, get a twirl, get a nose full, get your head in the glass, have a nose full out here, dip your head in, have a... It looks terrible, doesn't it? But get your lip up the glass, like that, so it fills everything, and then stop breathing in, hold that breath in, and get it on the tongue, get a nice gulp on the tongue, and then send a bit down the back of the throat and that. Breathe out, you don't have to do... Because that's a wine thing. Beer will kind of come up itself. It'll heat up itself. Breathe out. Get another breath in. Let it go around. You'll get all the flavours and everything. Because the olfactory system, flavours and taste, flavours and smells, aromas and everything else, they all talk to each other. They all talk to each other in one big harmony. So if you hold your nose, you don't taste nowhere near as well. You know, you taste with a little bit of the kind of thing going up the back and that, but you don't taste nowhere near as well. Sorry. You know how to taste things, but just try these things, you know. And sometimes even put a bit on the back of your wrist or something, like perfume. Have a little smell of it then as well. You know, especially with things like whiskies and things and whatever else. Anyway, sorry. Let's have another taste, see if I can bring anything else out. It's glorious. That's all I can say. Really glorious. You've got little fruity notes in there. Little edges of gooseberries, overripe cherries, things like that. Fruitier than I imagined. I thought it was going to be toffee, bit of honey, toffee. There's a bit of honey in there, by the way. Cashew nuts. There's tiny hints of all sorts of nuts. There's cashew nuts. There's little hints of hazelnuts, little hot almond edges and that. A tiny dryness of walnuts as well, but they're all in there kind of quiet and they're just doing the things in the background, little seedy jobs in the background, kind of sweeping up all that big malts and that. There's big malty flavours, big toffee honey sort of things going on. That is one glorious, glorious beer. Vanilla as well, little oaky edges. I don't know whether they oak this, but it's little oaky edges. That is lovely. Right, I'm going to finish there because I'm going to enjoy the rest of this. I usually gulp down whatever I've got in front of you and that, just to show how much I'm enjoying it, but I'm going to take my time with this now. This is, as I said, a little special for me, and I'm going to treat it special. So Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and glorious, glorious life to everyone here. Look after yourselves, look after each other, and I'll see you soon. See you in the next one. Don't be late, or I'll start without you. Biddly, biddly, boo. Bye.